Long story short, after a couple of days, you know, we finished dinner one night, which was, I'm going to say about a week and a half ago. And I said to my wife, you know, I'm really not feeling great. I said, I think we should take my temperature. So I took my temperature. I had a fever. So that's when we made the decision right then to send me down to where I am now, which is in our basement. So I've been here for about 10, 11 days. I had some mild symptoms for a couple of days, but never anything that I thought I had to, you know, seek treatment. So I communicated with a couple of doctors. Everybody said, you know, you're fine. Just do what you're doing. Stay home. So over the course of the last 10 days, you know, I had tried to and finally was able to successfully get a test through New York State's website. So I finally got a test. Took me a while to get through on the 800 number. And long story short, I finally was able to go to the drive-through test here in Westchester County where I lived yesterday. It was great. I mean, they had it very organized. It was pretty efficient. I waited about 20, 25 minutes. They did the test. They said, you're going to get an answer in about 48 to 72 hours. And it turned out I got the result within 24 hours on the website. They sent me an email and it said you came up positive. So, you know, luckily I've been down here, as I said already, for away from my wife and kids. My wife has been amazing, organizing the kids, bringing me food, leaving it to my little spot here, you know, taking the gloves and, you know, doing all the things that we were told to do. So now it's just a question of staying down here for a little bit longer. And then I suppose I'll have to get another test at some point to make sure it's cleared my system.
What would you say to, you know, anybody out there about your experience and just how to be careful and how to deal with what's going on?
Well, obviously, there's a lot of people that are having a hard time. And unfortunately, we're seeing the numbers go up of, you know, people that have lost their lives. So I consider myself extremely lucky. But I also consider myself probably a similar situation to what most people are going through, okay, which is that you get it, you have some mild symptoms, and your body's able to successfully fight it off. So that's what I've been able to do. I've been extra careful with, you know, the way I've handled it with my family and with my neighborhood and certainly my workplace, doing now as much as I can do from home. I just hosted a webinar for, you know, 100 of our kids at our tennis academy, so I continue to try to do that. But I would say that to most people out there, you know, you can get through this. You can fight through this. Just take the necessary precautions. Let's all do what we've been told to do, which is stay home, stay safe. And again, I just want to give a shout out to, you know, people that have lost loved ones or people that are really struggling. And I'm just happy that I wasn't at the point where I had to go to a hospital and get serious care like, you know, many people are obviously needing right now.